Welcome back. It seems that the perils of Rosella are nearly ended. We have defeated Lalotte. We have recovered the talisman. We even recovered the hen and Pandora's box. Which I guess is a good thing, since that's really not the kind of thing you want to leave lying around. All we need to do now is get the talisman back to Genesta and hope we can come back to Daventry in time to cure our father. Also, we better hope that we can make it down this staircase without dying. And I'd rather like to rescue that unicorn if we get the chance. At least the front door is no longer locked. You're standing before Lalotte's dark castle on the edge of the Rocky Mountain. There's a small stable next to it. Well, now that Lalotte is dead, hopefully Edgar will redecorate this place, makes it a bit nicer. The stable might be a good place to check out if you want to find a unicorn, though. And there it is! You've entered Lalotte's stable, and it looks like an ordinary stable at that. The poor unicorn has been imprisoned here. The unicorn looks at you with sadness. If I were the unicorn, I'd look at Rosella with anger, considering we were the one who trapped it. It needs to be free. Can we pet the unicorn again? Reassure it. You reach out to pet the unicorn's nose, but it won't let you. Well, I guess there's good reason for that. Let's open the gate. As soon as you open the gate, the splendid wild unicorn impatiently leaves its hated prison. It quickly trots out the open stable door to freedom. And then promptly falls down the cliff. Nah. Even Sierra games are not that cruel. Except possibly Leisure Suit Larry. That might happen there. Besides, I'm sure it's smarter than that. Okay. Unfortunately, we can't ask the Lord's goons to take us down. And as you can see, you can still fall here. You should be more careful, Rosella. I wasn't even close to the edge. Come on. This might actually be a bit easier to do with the mouse. Unlike later games, there's no pathfinding, so you do actually want to make sure you click in the right place, because Rosella will walk in a straight line towards your mouse cursor, even if that takes her over a cliff. Or if there's an object in the way. Okay. Now all we need to do is get back to Genesta. Wait, no. There is something else. You might think that's true, but it's not. After all, we still have Pandora's box. And, you know, I really don't think that's a good thing to be carrying around. So, let's return it to where we found it. I actually almost forgot about that. Good thing I didn't. Would have cost me some points. Okay. Let's just put it back where we found it. Look out for the mummy. Who still runs from our powerful scarab. And put the box back. Which gets the special fanfare. And finally, let's lock the door. Oh, we need to close it first. Then, let's lock it. You place a skeleton key in the lock of the crypt door. Click. It's locked. You kick the key through a crack under the door. Now no one will ever accidentally release the evils of Pandora's box into the world. Yes, I'm sure. Unless somebody comes here with some power tools and just breaks through the door, but anyway. Now we have to go back to Janesta and give her a talisman. I hope I didn't forget anything. We will find out soon enough whether or not I got the total number of points. If I did forget something, I have honestly no idea what it is. You might think there's something we need to do with the chicken or something, but we obviously don't want to give it back to the ogre. So there's nothing we can do with that poor little hen. Swimming is still a dangerous occupation in this game, so we want to swim from the pier because that decreases the distance. I don't think the whale will show up again. But there's still a shark, and you can still tire and die that way. So let's swim back to Janesta's island. And hope we are in time to save her. Let's hope it has not yet been 24 hours. Peacock still running around. You can visit all of these places during the night as well. I didn't do that because there's not really any reason to. But you can if you want to. Janesta's fairy still guarding the door. And we know the way. All we have to do is go up to where Janesta is sleeping and give her the talisman. And then we will be done with the game, if I'm not mistaken. Which I know I'm not, so... Give talisman to Janesta. You give the magic talisman to the dying fairy. Almost instantly, the color returns to her cheeks and her green eyes begin to sparkle. She sits up in bed, stretches, and smiles at you. Really, it's not such a good idea to have an object that your life is so dependent on. I told Sauron that, and he didn't believe me. Seems Janesta hasn't taken that advice either. She awakens! You have saved my life, Rosella, the beautiful fairy says gratefully. And you have saved Tamir from the persecution of Lalot. We are deeply indebted to you. And it looks like we are missing 2 points, but we'll get those. You just wait. I want to go outside. I need to feel the warm sun on my face. Exuberantly, she waves her magic wand. Suddenly, you find yourself outside. My little hen! Janesta suddenly exclaims. Wherever did you find her? That's the final 2 points. You explain that the ogre had possession of her. Poor thing, she says. Well, at least she's back home now. And everyone's happy. Now for you, Rosella, Janesta says. It's my turn to help you out. I will return you to Daventry, and with the magic fruit you will be able to save your father's life. We'd better hurry, though, as he doesn't have much time left. Yes, you are anxious to get home again. But first, Janesta proclaims, let's replace these peasant clothes with your royal gown. That would be nice. With a twinkle in her eye, Janesta announces, there is someone else deserving of a reward for his kindness and heroism. Yeah, sure, it's not like we're in a hurry to save our father or anything. You have a beautiful soul, Edgar, the fairy says to the ugly little man. You should look like what you are. Ooh, he turns into a handsome guy. This handsome hunk is Edgar? Rosella, he says, I love you. Will you marry me? You think about it. You think about it some more. Then, I'm sorry, Edgar. You're very sweet, but I must immediately return home. Perhaps we'll meet again, you say. I do like that. Well, Rosella, Janessa announces, it's time for you to go. Your father needs you. Goodbye. We'll never forget you. I like that she doesn't marry him, that she doesn't just rush off into marriage with the first stranger she meets. Ooh, and she gets the adventurer's hat. You give the healing fruit to your dying father and strongly urge him to take a bite, which he weakly does. How are you feeling, father? You excitedly ask him. Never felt better in my life, is his reply. What is in this fruit, anyway? He wonders. It is magic, father, and you tell your excited family of your adventure in Tamir. I don't think you're through with this head yet, you say. Your brother Alexander and your mother, Queen Valenice, readily agree. You've got too much life ahead of you. And we did it! We saved our father and helped a fairy in the process. And that takes us to the end of yet another King's Quest game. King's Quest 4 represents a significant step forward in terms of graphics and especially sound, but unfortunately, it's a bit of a step backward in terms of gameplay, in my opinion. The game is the most elaborate story so far. The gameplay is more reminiscent of the first two games, and not as good as King's Quest 3. There are too many frustrating bits, like the whale's tongue and the troll cave, and too many instances where you're doing things just because the game lets you, rather than because you know why, like the grave digging. The lot also just doesn't have the presence that Mananan did as a bad guy. The game definitely wins points for atmosphere, though, and I really like the fact that you can visit the same locations during both the day and night. Adds some really nice touches to it. The music is also quite good and really was groundbreaking for a video game in the late 80s. The game is also notable for having a strong female lead character, and I've always liked how the King's Quest games let you take control of different members of Daventry's royal family. Speaking of Graham and his family, surely their troubles are over, and they'll live happily ever after now. Find out next time in King's Quest V, Absence Makes the Heart Go Yonder.